here with me, my brother in Christ. Ain't God good, church? I don't know about you, but God is good. God is still God. Amen. Praise God. I know there's a lot of announcements that's going to be made. I'm going to let the pastor make a lot of them. He's got some announcements he needs to be made. But I don't know about you, but this morning I come to serve the Lord. I come to worship the Lord this morning. I don't know about you, but this morning I come to hear a word from the Lord. Amen. With that being said, praise God. Let us go to the Lord in prayer. Dear Lord, Heavenly Father, God, I just praise you and I magnify you, dear Lord, Father God. Dear Lord, Father God, in all circumstances, dear Lord, Father God, in good, in bad, dear Lord, Father God, you are still God, dear Lord, Father God. You are still the great I am, dear Lord, Father God, from the time, dear Lord, Father God, in the Garden of Eden, dear Lord, Father God, from the time of leading the children out of Israel, and dear Lord, Father God, even in this time, dear Lord, Father God, that even seems uncertain to some of us, dear Lord, Father God, you have a way. You have a way of escape and a way out, dear Lord, Father God. And we give you the praise and the glory, Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Praise God. At this time, I've asked Brother John to say the prayer over the offering. Here you go, Brother John.
Y'all bow with me. Father God, we thank you so much for this assembly today. Father, we thank you so much for providing all of our needs. And as we give into the trays this morning, Father, we know that you're going to bless everything that's put in today, God, to bless those who are giving and who can't. In Jesus' name, amen.
Times and high waters on the road that I have wandered, bridges left burning, a lot of dead and learning. Stone walls I built up, trapped by the way I'm living. I don't want to be a prisoner. I don't want to be a prisoner. We'll see.
Thank you.
free.
You were the Word in the beginning, the one with God, the Lord Most High. You're hidden in glory and creation, now revealed in you are Christ. What a beautiful name it is. What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a beautiful name it is. Nothing compares to this. What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus. You didn't want heaven without us, so Jesus, you brought heaven down. My sins was great, your love was greater. What could separate us now? What a wonderful name it is. What a wonderful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a wonderful name it is. What compares to this? What a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus. Death could not hold you. The veil tore before you. The praise of forever, God, you reign. Yours is the kingdom. Yours is the glory. Yours is the name above all names. What a powerful name it is. What a powerful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a powerful name it is. Nothing can stand against. What a powerful name it is.
The name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Go ahead and give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Go ahead. Brother Kevin Miles said, for the next 30 seconds, give him your best praise in the house. Woo! Glory to God. Amen. Glory. Yes, Lord. Amen. Glory to God. Brother Pee Wee said this morning, Brother Anthony, I always call him Pee Wee. You know who he is. He said, they are not having children's church. They're going to stay in here. So, you know, we are telling people be cautious. Be what they're telling you to do is what you should have been doing the whole time. You should have already been stocked up with a little bit. You should have already been prepared. And you should always wash your hands. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. That ain't, they're not teaching you no strange doctrine. Our government's telling us, wash your hands, be safe, stay 6 foot apart. We're telling people when you come in, sit with your family and sit a distance from people and be cautious. Be, you know, pay attention to what our officials are saying. But amen. I got to be careful because I'm one of them type people. I don't like this messenger. This is where I understand our president's situation. If he don't declare an emergency, if he don't do what he's doing, every case is on him. And then as a pastor, if you have church, if somebody ends up with corona, and my God, if you got it, you've already had it before today because it was going on a month before we even realized in Mississippi. So I said, if we had it, we already got it. Glory to God. So, you know, maybe Wednesday or whenever, I don't know. But if you dismiss church, you You know, where's your trust and where's your hope? And then if you have church, if someone gets it, if the pastor were to listen to the officials, then wouldn't no one have got sick? Listen, you're going to get sick anyway. Glory to God, not from the corona. I was sitting in my desk praying today, and I said, Lord, help me not to meddle, but help me preach the gospel and be real and stay in the word of God and stay out of myself. I pray that every time, and I'm sitting there praying, trying to mind my own business. And I said, Lord, help me, Jesus, because you got to be careful some of the things you said. Yeah, I'm just going to go and put it out there. Listen, if you're watching live stream, you get mad, don't you go talking to nobody. Come talk to me. If I said something you would disagree with, talk to me. I ain't scared of one of you, none of you, all of you. I just, what I say is what I mean. But I was sitting there praying, and I mean, it just come over me that there's going to be more people die from stupid than they are corona. I might have to come over here. They got it, but I didn't hear nothing over here. There are going to be more people this year die from stupid than they are corona. And they probably going to be a lot of deaths. But there's a lot of folks going to die from being drunk, being high, being all kinds of things that happen in the world, driving in the vehicle. Anything can happen. Glory to God. You listen, you're going to die one day anyway. They're going to lay this old body down, but they can't touch the spirit. He said, don't fear them things that can touch your body, but things touch your soul, life and all. We preach about being ready to go see Jesus. You know, it's like that old man, they said, everyone who wants to go be with the Lord, you know, and no one raised up their hand but one fella. He said, you know, I thought everybody was ready to go see the Lord. We thought you were getting low tonight. That's the way it is. We either preach what we preach and believe what we preach or we don't. So we're going to practice safety. We want people, hey, I've told them, I said it Wednesday night, if you need to stay home, stay home. Especially if you got some kind of ailment or you older, be careful and keep your distance, wash your hands. My God, I've been preaching that for 13 years. You know, if there's someone sitting next to you that don't smell good, get them some deodorant. This would be a good thing to brush your teeth too. Now I'm meddling. I got to stay in the Word. I was sitting there reading that. Man, he said, why do you think you preached on Gideon 2 or 3 weeks ago? He said, I'm trying to speak to you. Because, listen, and they put it out there on Facebook, because we got a lot of wisdom, so we got to be careful and listen to the wisdom, because it is. So there are some people that have finally figured out the building is not the church. And we preached that for 13 years. This is the temple. This is where he lives. But most people that, here I am, I got a word to preach, and I'm already meddling, because Brother Kevin, listen, I sit in the back, Pee-wee says some things that I got to watch myself, because when them things get in my head, I'll always say it, but I'm going to point Pee-wee out. And then something gets in my head, it was John said it. If it comes out, I'm going to say, that's what John, but you don't think about it. John said, when the Lord comes, will he find faith on earth? Glory to God. The scriptures is coming live before our eyes. Man, think about it. Now, that wasn't mine. I wished I penned it. It's in the Bible. You know, I didn't create that. It's just in there. Glory to God. This is what I'm doing. I'm sitting there. He said, why do you think I give you Gideon? Why do you think I give? I wanted to go. We're living in perilous times. That's what I really wanted to preach. We're living in perilous times, because we are. But the Lord wouldn't let me preach that. I ended up somewhere I ain't even been reading over there, to where he gave me a title, said, there's only one God. And I'm thinking, God, why you got me going there? He said, why do you think I carried you to Gideon? I'm trying to teach you something. See, we're controlled by everything. Most people, we get done, we probably won't be 4 or 5 families. That's okay. God can build on that. If your foundation's Christ, I'm telling you. Most people won't darken the door of a church, not even in Christ, not in nothing. But the very people that's scared to come to church and gather touch gas pumps. They'll go to the grocery store. They'll go to the... God forbid we don't go to work. We got to have our manna. I'm preaching to you already. There's only one God. He ain't sharing his glory with corona. He ain't sharing his glory with cancer. He ain't sharing his glory with diabetes. He ain't sharing his glory with nothing. He's God and he stands alone. Ain't nothing got control over him. Ain't nothing took him by surprise. Ain't nothing shocked him. He's not at home today taking Maalox saying, oh my God, what am I going to do? He ain't took I got some people already. If they blow up live stream, tell them call me. 720-2241. They can talk to me. I just preach the word and live out the word. If I believe what I preach, my God, I thought about dismissing church in Devon. Let's just stop and don't go. And God said, you're going to go to work next week? You're going to go get some groceries next week? I was like, you're going to get some gas when your truck gets low? You're going to wash your hands when you get done? He said, go there, tell the people be safe, sit six feet apart, wash your nasty hands. You should have done washed them. I'm in trouble, ain't I? Hey, brother, I'm just preaching. You got it tonight. I'll let you be led by the Lord. There is only one God. Worship him. His name is Jesus. I'm telling you something. Right now, we're finding out who's lapping and who ain't. Not none. Don't get upset, church. I know New Covenant. They've been taught the word for 14 years, and we poured it into you. I'm not saying, hey, if you meant glory to God, be safe. But when I see you in Walmart and you're in that full suit, I'll be like, yeah, you got it now. Pee-wee told me that, and that's a good one. I told you I'd throw you on the but that's good. Well, we're going to wear gloves, pump gas, and we'll use that same glove to thank God for common sense. Thank God for warriors. You're going to need them. You're going to need them. What happened was God said, listen, you got too many. As you get down there that water, he said, I'm going to show you who to pick out. You're going to go fight against 32,000 people with 300. I'm preaching out of Gideon. Now I'm back to Gideon because the Lord told me at my desk, he said, why you think you taught on Gideon? I'm safe. I'm just being honest. We've got to proceed because I don't know what the future. They say it's something about lives. Well, I'm going to tell you something. The flu kills a lot of people, so we need to shut down during the flu. Shut down. What are you saying? I'm just preaching the word. Leave me alone. I'm going to preach. There's only one God. I meddle. My meddling's out, so now I'm going to get into the word. This is where the Lord carried me. I really wanted to preach on perilous times, but you already know you're in dangerous times. You're more likely to die from an asteroid than you are some of the other stuff that has gripped people. Amen. Listen to what it says in James 14, 2 and 14. And I'm going to try to stay in the word this morning. I done got my meddling out. I've already got people, you know, that are probably upset. I'm not just trying to pinpoint no one out. I'm just trying to be honest. Where is your confidence? Where is your faith? Where's your hope? Where's your joy? Brother John, you said it right. When Jesus returns, I've preached it in this church before. Will he find faith on earth? Listen, when the Holy Spirit spoke to me, Sister Sarah, and told me, you know, I really contemplated canceling. And we are going to cancel tonight and Wednesday night, and we're going to live stream. Someone's going to preach still. Word's going to go out. They may play a song. We are going to try to be careful. We are going to try to do right. Next Sunday morning, unless the Lord leads us different, we'll have service. If you need to be at home and be stay at home, if you can't come and have enough sense to wash your hands and sanitize yourself and be 6 foot away from one another, you need to stay home. Amen. It's truth. But if you can do it and be in precaution, do it right. Because listen, when he told me, Brother John, if you're going to go to work, if you're going to do the things you're going to do, if you're going to go get gas, if you're going to go to the store, if you're going to, well, we got to have them things. I got to have the Spirit of God more than I got to have all them things combined. He's been teaching us that in the Word of God forever. He said, put your trust in God, not in man. You got to put your hope and your joy and your faith and your confidence all in Christ. Glory to God. Don't worry about laying this body down. It's going to happen. You just need to be ready. Woo! Glory to God. 14 says, what doeth it profit, my brother, though a man say he has faith and has not works? This presents the fact that proper faith will always produce proper works. You got faith? You got faith in what? You got faith in God. Amen? I believe this is what I felt like the Spirit of the Lord laid in my heart. If you're going to go get gas and you're going to go to the store and you're going to go do all these things, but you can't trust me to protect you here, I liable's the more likely get it anyway. So I said, Lord, I'm going to trust you. If I got it, I already got it. If it's been here for 3 months, we don't know where it's at. Glory to God. And when you're at work, you don't know where no one's been. You don't know who's touched that gas pump. That's why I said, wash your hands, use some sanitizer. All right, let's go. He said, if a brother or sister be naked and in destitute of daily food, and one of you saying to them, depart in peace, be ye warmed and filled, notwithstanding you give them not those things which are needed to the body, what doeth it profit you? Listen, this refers to the claim that faith, which blesses no one. Boy, that gets you in trouble. Watch this. This is claiming that faith, which blesses no one, simply because it's not true faith. True faith will help the people. True faith will have substance. True faith will be there for. True faith will help. True faith will feed. True faith will dress. It comes down to this right here in the scriptures I was reading. I'm about to pray. That if you got faith without works, it's dead. If I just said, go you and be warm and do nothing, that is faith, but it's faith without works, which is dead. And one of my last scriptures that I'm going to preach today is faith that the body without the spirit is dead. You know what that means? That means if that body is laying there lifeless of the Spirit of God, it is dead. That body's not going to feed you. That body's not going to do nothing for you. That body's over with. Their time has come and gone. It's dead. So faith is like that body lifeless of the Spirit of God. It is dead without works. Let's pray. Brother Sean, pray over the remainder. Pray over this service. Glory to God. Amen. I've been quoting saying if I had it, I've already had it because, you know, Dennis told me Wednesday night, I was talking to him a little bit about it. I said, man, you just need to be careful, especially in your field. He said, listen, everybody's been exposed to it. I thought, man, that's pretty powerful. That just, you know, practice what they tell you. Stay clean. Stay safe. I'm going to stress that very reason. Like tonight, we're going to be live streaming, but you don't have to come. Wednesday nights, you don't have to come. It's going to live stream. Watch it live. Be safe. You know, do the, but man, do it right. Brother Travis is going to preach. More than likely, I'll be here to cheer him on. Amen. But it don't take just, he said, we're two or three gathered in my name. I am in the midst. Amen. So the good Lord's going to be here. If it ain't but two, if it ain't but three, if it ain't but one, God's going to be preached out of this church. Amen. And God's going to reach a community of people that's hungry for the things of God. Listen to what it says. I want to get through today. So I got to get started. Amen. And it's just now 5 after 11. So bear with me because we got somebody getting baptized. She was saying last week she wanted to be baptized. So if nothing else, it would have been 4 or 5 of us and her getting baptized. But we was having service for no other reason. Now, like I said, the rest of it's on. Just pray about your decisions. It says in verse 17, even so, faith, if it has not works, is dead, being alone. Do you understand that? Does that really register with you? Does it really hit home? I got faith, but listen, I'm going to tell you something. That right now, you're figuring out more people have a concern for manna than they do. I'm telling you a fact. Amen. Now, there's going to be some people that's going to be in a bind. The church is fixing to have to be the church that she's always said she was right now in time. Because there are going to be some people that ain't going to be able to have that job. They're not going to be able to work. And then we're going to have to try to feed them. We're going to have to, until we run out of means, we'll have to feed, we'll have to bless, we'll have to be a hospital to the earth. Glory to God. Feed my sheep. We'll have to be feeding some sheep is what will have to happen. But the church is going to have, man, I feel the presence of the Holy Ghost in this place so strong right now. I feel the anointing so powerful. We're going to have to be the church, but we're going to have faith that withstands everything the enemy tries to hurl our way. He's every fiery dart. Listen to what it's saying. He's saying, I want to share this. As stated, proper faith will produce proper works. If not, the Holy Spirit says here that it is dead faith. In other words, if faith don't produce works, me and Sean's talked about that before. If you got faith, faith's going to produce something. If you say you love someone, it's going to produce something. If you say you got faith, listen, if I did like some, but what if I just decided, you know, I got to be careful, really, Kevin. I'll let you. What if I just decide, you know, I'm not going to do nothing? And what if you decide you're not going to do nothing? And what if you decide you're not going to do nothing? You decide you're not going to do it. Is that faith? Faith has proper works. It's empty if it does has no, it don't produce no works. There's works in our life. We got people preach against work. Works ain't for you. Works is for getting people into the kingdom of God. It's your good works that glorify your Father, which is in heaven. It's what draws people. So they got to be drawn by Spirit anyway. So if there's no one doing nothing, there's no... See, he's not sharing his glory, so it's God anyway. So all you do is preach Jesus and preach him crucified. Did you know Jesus is God all by himself? I got some scriptures I'm going to show you in a minute on that. There was an angel over there in John. When John, in Revelations, when John began to bow down and worship him, he said, don't do that. I'm of the brotherhood just like you. I got here by the testimony of Jesus Christ. They worship Jesus all through the New Testament, and all through the New Testament, Jesus didn't tell them don't do that because he was God. Listen to what I'm about to tell you this morning. In verse 18, it says, yes, a man may say you have faith and I have works. Show me your faith without your works, and I will show you my faith by my works. You know what he was saying? Show me your faith without works. In other words, vice versa, if you look at it, he says, yes, a man may say you have faith and I have works. In other words, one has works and one just has faith, but you got to have the two together, because what he's saying in verse 18, he said, show me your faith without works and I'll show you my faith by my works. In other words, when you have faith and some works with it, there's going to be something happen. I can look at my yard and say, glory to God. My yard looks good. I ain't got to do nothing else to my yard. Glory to God. God blessed me with that yard. That yard looks good. I ain't going to do nothing else to that yard. Guess what happens? In about a month, it's going to be growed up. I got faith that's going to be took care of. But if it's going to look good, I'm like, if it's going to get down manicured and took care of, I'm going to have some works with my faith. It's going to be took care of, but I'm going to have some works to take care of it. Because if you go study in the scripture, there is a scripture that talks about, I seen the man that sat idle with his arms crossed and wouldn't do nothing, and his place growed up because he didn't have no wisdom, didn't have enough sense to take care of what God gave him. Now listen. And I'm going to get into some things this morning. I love speaking about faith. I love speaking about the Word of God. I love preaching about God is God all by himself. Woo! It said, you believe that there is one God? He said, you do well. The devils also believe and tremble. Listen, I want to share this with you. This proclaimed the fact I'm going to read this to you. Presents the type of faith that held by hundreds and millions, but which there is no saving grace. Just by, you know, you believe in God. Listen, I'm going to share it with you. The devil also believes, and trembles. It says, simply believing there is a God says no more than what the demons believe. Proper faith will accept the Lord Jesus Christ as one Savior. You know, just believing don't make you no different than a demon. To have the faith and then the drawing of the Spirit and then to accept him as your Savior, that's faith with works that gets your name wrote in the Lamb's Book of Life. That's what takes place. So faith has to have some action to it. Faith has to have some substance to it. Faith has to have some works to it, because, you know, there even one of the past scriptures I'm going to give you said, can faith save you? So you can get in trouble right there. People live stream and they'll misuse this. They'll miss this. It can't. Don't touch that speaker for a week. Glory to God. I'm not humorous for making fun of them. A lot of people died, man. They 40-something people in the church died. The people in New York City, 4 people in their family died. Use, you know, some wisdom and stay the distance, wash your hands. I'm not making light of it. I'm just telling you, there's a remnant of people, glory to God. It don't matter what rises up. Jesus didn't run from everything that popped up. He just stood there and kept preaching the gospel. He said, I'm the way, the truth, and the light, and no man come to the Father but by me. But he had faith. When a leopard come in there, he just grabbed a hold of leprosy. I would have probably said, bring me the gloves. I'm just being honest. You know, the corona's here. Stay 6 foot. Wash your hand. Guess what? When I touch your nasty hand, I'm washing mine. And now y'all, see, I told you it didn't matter. Pastors don't win nowhere. Now, if you close down church, you ain't calls me home. And I'm standing up there, and he said, you dismissed church for 2 months. But you little nappy-headed rascal, you kept going to work. I noticed you hadn't missed many meals, so you kept going to the grocery store. I noticed that your billfold's full and your belly's full. He said, but I was watching from on high, and I noticed that your head was empty. I got a word for it. I'm going to come into that. Because faith that's dead is the empty head. If it's dead, it's dead. Huh? I said it in the beginning. I know the Lord spoke it to my heart. There'll be more people die from stupid than there are any kind of these diseases have been here since the beginning of the time. And if you read your scriptures in the end time, there are going to be plagues that are going to pop up all the time. Think about it. But that don't mean we stop preaching, teaching, doing the things God called us to do. Huh? That's why I said you can stay home. I'm still going, somebody going to preach tonight, so we're going to preach Wednesday night. Next Sunday morning, Lord willing, unless I'm raptured out. If I'm raptured out, somebody else can preach. But I plan on being here. And if it gets bad to where it's just spreading like wildfire like it's doing, and they say cancel it down, it'll just be me and my wife and the live streamer and glory to God. Maybe someone sing special or sing it on the whatever we got to do. But we going to have faith enough to trust God that I'm going to say, God, I'd hate to be in a place to where I ain't got enough faith in you to take care of me. And I always have. In the 23 years of being saved, I trusted him when others did. God said, you don't do as others. You do as I. And you keep going forward. You keep preaching. You keep teaching. Glory to God. And he'll take care of the rest. When he calls you, you going anyway. You listen, when a tornado's coming and I get in that storm and I hadn't yet, my wife wouldn't go in last time. Tornado went close and she wouldn't go in. So I went to bed. Going to be bad. The house going to be tore up and blown away, and they're going to be looking for us in the storm room. We ain't in the storm room. There's weather out there and all that debris. Didn't have enough sense to get in that storm room. But even if I get in the storm room, if the Lord's ready for me, I got a 4-inch vent pipe up there. You don't think that a 2x4 can go through that? If he's ready for me, you'll come in there and find me with a 2x4 through my head. What am I saying? Well, he calls you, you are going. Yes, you can rush it. But if he's ready for you, you're going. He was ready for Lazarus to come out of that grave. Man, I've been preaching this for weeks. He was ready for Lazarus to come out of that grave. You know what happened? He said, Lazarus, come forth. Lazarus was dead, wrapped up in mummy clothes. His spirit was already with the saints of old. I'm just paraphrasing. I couldn't find it. It's not even, but I'm telling you what I believe took place. I believe Abraham and Isaac and Jacob. He said, man, it's so good to see all y'all, man. I'm so glad to see y'all, man. Saints of old, I'll get in touch with y'all. He said, wait a minute. Wait a minute, guys. I don't know why. I don't know why, but I'm being called back. I got to go back to that body that's wrapped up like a mummy. I'm being called. I got to go. I got to go. I got to go. And then he back up. Here I am back wrapped up. What you want, Jesus? I was already dead. I was already in a good place. You know, call me back to this old body. Now I feel wrapped up like a mummy. Because he was. And Jesus told him, said, go remove the stone.
roll it out of the way. Yeah. I'm glad we didn't have a lot of singing this morning. I got a little more time to preach. I'm going to give you all of it. I'm unloading everything. He said, roll that away. And when they rolled it away, here come Lazarus come be bobbing out. Woo, he said, unwrap him. They unwrapped him. He's thinking, man, see, you don't understand. He was already in a good place. He had to come back, get up in that old dead body with his spirit, and then walk out of there because Jesus called for him. And when he calls from you, I don't care if you're 57 and I don't care if you're 97. When he calls you, he knows you by name. Huh? Some of y'all, he's going to say, you hairy rascal, come on up hither. And some of you, he's going to say, skin top, come on up hither. He knows how many hairs you got. He knows you by name, Brother Jarvis. He knows who you are. He knows where you are. And when he's ready for us, it don't matter if we're in a grave. It don't matter if we're in a tomb. It don't matter if we're at the house. It don't matter if we're in a storm room. It don't matter if we're up under a rock. It don't matter what's going on. When he calls us, we go. Woo! Boy, that's I'm telling you something. That's something to skin your teeth on. Listen, you better have a little faith. See, I just know for a fact, because they ain't saints of old ain't here preaching to you this morning. I know for a fact one day I got to lay down and sleep. You know how I said sleep? I am going to pap. I'm going to sleep. I'm still going to be waiting. See, right now I'm looking towards that way. Then I'm just going to be asleep waiting. Hey, the body going to be asleep. The spirit going to be with the Lord. Oh, praise God. I can't get into all that. I ain't got time. Let me get back over here. I ain't got time. Where'd you get, brother? But wilt thou know, O vain man, that faith without works is dead? Huh? Listen, in effect, James Bruntley says, anyone who trusts in an empty faith has, in effect, an empty head. I told you I was going to bring the ass in the commentary. Someone said, where'd you get that? I read it. Someone said, leave the commentaries alone. I'm just telling you that if I have no faith with no actions, then I'm empty. That's what that's saying. I'm empty. You're empty. Listen. Let's move on quickly. He said, was not Abraham, our father, justified by works when he offered up Isaac, his son, upon the altar? Listen to what he said. He said, seest thou how faith wrought with his works, and by works was faith made perfect. Is y'all reading the same thing I'm reading? My Bible may be different than a lot of people's Bible. I'm just trying to get it out here so we can understand. It says, and the scripture was fulfilled, which said, Abraham believed God, and it was imputed to him, I can't say that word right, imputed to him for righteousness. And he was called the friend of God. Listen, he said, you see then how that by works a man is justified and not by faith only? In other words, he had faith, but he had works. It wasn't faith only. It wasn't works only. It was faith with works. It was works with faith. Sure, he believed God. He trusted God. But what if he said, yeah, God, you know I got faith. You know I trust you. You know I believe in you. But me and Isaac's just going to stay here. No. I told you to go up on the hill. I told you to take some firewood. I told you to take a lamb. I told you to take Isaac and offer your only son. Well, I got faith. You know I would do that. Sort of sounds like today. You know I got faith. Yeah, I know. You know I trust God. I know. You know I can walk on water. I know. You know I can cast out demons. I know. I'm just going to be honest with you. When it comes to casting out demons, out of all the people that I know, it's going to get people mad, Brother Randy, but this is the truth. If I'm going to cast out some devils in the name of Jesus, first of all, I'm going to make sure the Spirit of God's with me. I'm going to make sure he told me to go. Second person I really want's my wife. Now, I know she got faith and she's believing. Huh? Think about it. I live with her. I know what I'd be like. I'm going to need your help. We're going to pray. We're going to believe God. You got to be careful. Some people you go. You take the certain people with you that have good, sweet, pretty words but have no actions. They got faith with no works. If you take them with you, your feelings is going to be hurt. Huh? Because I've seen some of them that's got that. I'd hate to see them naked running out the door. That would hurt your feelings. Where'd you get that? It's in there. It's in there. It's in Acts. Go read it. And folk bebop up in there and said, in the name of Jesus Christ, I adjure thee, come out. And the devil was in the man said, Jesus, I know. Paul, I know. I'm not quite sure I know who you are. I don't quite know who you, Let's keep it where we can understand. Who is you? Where you come from? I'm going to have somebody with me got a backbone. Amen? Don't take it out of context because you can twist it any way you want to twist. You twist the Bible any way you want to twist. Huh? I just said I'd have my wife with me, brother. I know she's got that. I know she bleeds. She got on me last night. She said, we ain't got nowhere we can go eat. We just go through a drive-thru. I said, well, I got stuff at home. She said, you're so paranoid. I said, I'm not paranoid. I got stuff to eat at home. Huh? And if we go through the drive-thru, I want a Whopper. I want to go to Burger King. She don't like Burger King. Because I'm a King's kid. King's kids like Whoppers. Huh? Where'd y'all go? I got to quit, man. I got to stay in this. Huh? He said, in verse 24, let's go. In verse 25 says, likewise also was Rahab the harlot justified by works. When she had received the messengers and had sent them out another way. So she had faith, but there had to be some actions. Even she had to tell the people they went thus and thus and thus and sent them a different direction. So it was her faith with her works that saved her whole family. Listen to what I'm telling you. So this is what takes place. He said, this presents one of the most beautiful stories of faith found in the amends of human history. This was proper faith which produced proper works. I've been preaching that since I've been saved. Proper faith produces proper works. I'll never forget. I'm going to share something going to blow some people out of water. It's a true story. Unless he lied. It's just what he said. He could have lied. I don't know. There was a man named Dan Livingston. Years ago, I went to a revival he was at. He was preaching. I really wasn't saved, but I was going, you know, and I said, I'm going to go and hear this man. People, man, they said he is on fire. He's preaching the word. So I went. Dan said that God had called him to New York City. He said he went to New York City on a little missions trip. He said he got there, and he said he was standing on the street corner and said there was a little girl. Said she's like 13, 14 years old. He said she come through there hanging on two or three guys, and they had her, and you could tell that. And she was, you can do what you want, And he said he was standing there. And he said he was holding a sign. He was sitting there leaning against a sign like a pole or something. And if I remember the story right, he said, the Spirit of the Lord spoke to him. Now, he was raised in Florida or had a church in Florida or whatever. And his people was, man, fantastic churches full of people. Just had much people, a lot of people. And he said he's always heard faith, faith, faith. God, take care of you. God, you trust God. You do what God tells you to do. No matter what no one else says, you do what God tells you. And he said, the Lord spoke to him and said, this is where I want you. He said, he looked around, he thought, I don't know about no New York City. This is where I want you for people like that. He goes home. He tells his family. He tells his pastor. He tells his people at church. He tells everyone. They said, you will starve plumb to death in New York City. Sound like somebody had some faith without works. Because if he calls you to New York City, it'd be my responsibility to try to help you get to New York City. Amen. Especially if you're raised up here and God's called you, I think you ought to be one of the number ones we should support, and we should exceed what we do other places, because you'd be a missionary or a preacher out here. So we definitely need to make sure you get your means. But you will starve plumb to death. You'll never make it in New York City. He said, man, that messed with him. He said, that tore him up. That messed with him bad. He said, he went back home. And I'm preaching his message. I'm just trying to remember how it went. But he said, that messed with me bad. He said, here it was, my pastor that I've heard preach, faith, 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 faith. Then he said, you starve to death, starve to death. He was like, where's the faith? You've taught me faith. Now you tell me I'm a star. So he said he prayed about it, and he said, his family, his people, his pastor, all of them telling him, you crazy, you've lost your mind, you started it, you can't do it. He said he got there, he said about the first 3 or 4 months, he thought, I'm going to starve plumb to death. He said, but then God started supplying. Food started coming. Things got, he said, man, that was reaching people, leading people to Christ and the restaurants, leading, it was just packed out with junkies and prostitutes and everything was coming in and getting saved and getting Jesus and everything getting right. He said, it was just fantastic. God was moving. But my point was, we teach faith, 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 but when God calls you to do something, you're an idiot. You're crazy. Noah over there building that boat. And they were like, you crazy old man, it ain't never rain. What are you doing? He's like, listen, rain's coming. Y'all better get ready. Listen, Jesus is coming. I like the quote that was on Facebook. If people was as worried about hell as much as they are corona disease, there would be a lot of people coming to Jesus today. Think about that. Huh? Don't get mad at me. I didn't put it in there. I just read it. It was in there. That's a good quote. That's the fact. We scared of everything else. How about have faith in God and trust God and glory to God? Don't you cry for me if I die. Woo! And I don't care what gets me. You hear me? I got Jesus and the Holy Ghost lives in this body. And when he calls me, I got to go. I'm like anyone else. I hope it's in the rapture. But if not, I'm okay with that, sister, sir. However he chooses, I'm in, because I do know he's got control of my life. A true believer, he's got control of your life. That's what Psalm, my God, everyone's quoted Psalm 91. No plague will come nigh thy dwelling. If you full of the Holy Ghost and believe that, then walk in it. Quit quoting it if you don't believe it. Shut your mouth. You sound good, but you don't. Woo! Brother Jarvis, I just got fired. It's okay. He may call me in New York City. I'll have about a month before I starve to death. He's told this. Help me, Lord. I don't want to get in trouble. I better stay. I'll have to stay. Be careful with that. I've been preaching about the ant forever. You know what that means? If you live in an area, you got 3 months of bad weather and you build houses, you better have you about 3 months supply in case something goes crazy and a bunch of clowns run to Walmart and get all the toilet paper. I said, not clowns, people. I didn't mean it. I try, sister. I really do. It's all right. If y'all fire me, they'll have me. I got places I can go to church. You hear me? There's people that they'll let me come to church. They just may not let me preach. They'll be like, you come to church and sit there and be quiet and be a good little boy. Only thing we want you to do is when a giant comes and get your rock. You don't know who my rock is. My rock is Jesus Christ. That's my rock. I can fight against any giant. Whoa, I don't get preaching. I'm living it out. When the giant raises up his head, I said, meet my rock. Glory to God. You just got stoned. Now, back in the day, that'd have meant something else. But I tell them today, you just got stoned by the rock. Glory to God. He got my back. He's taking care of me. I probably won't sleep over 8 or 9 hours tonight. She knows I don't sleep that much, no way. But I'll probably have everyone, well, I ain't bit them off yet, but I'll probably chew all my nails off. And I probably won't know what to do with myself. But I guarantee you this much, when I lay down and go to sleep, I pray and I say, Father, thank you. Thank you for your hedge. Thank you for your protection. Thank you for your love. And I prayed, Lord, if you want me by Corona, just call me. I'm more likely going to die eating bologna than Corona. If I keep eating like I'm eating, I ain't going to have to worry about no. My wife even gets on to me, slow down. I'm afraid to, man. Sean's coming over. Amen. I'm just messing with you. Glory to God. Listen to what it says. I really want you to get this one. This is one of the keys. What am I preaching? I'm preaching. There's only one God. Worship Him. His name is Jesus. And I got proof. Because if it wasn't, that angel over in Revelations when John bowed down to worship Him would have let him worship Him. But he said, no, see that you do it not. I'm just like you are. And got here by the testimony of Jesus Christ. Don't you do that. You ain't found nowhere in there where Jesus did. He told him, said, man, don't be worshiping me. He said, me and my Father are one. They worship Jesus, and we still worship Jesus. And he accepts it. Why? Because he's God. He's not been dethroned. He's sitting on the right hand of the Father. You don't think that he didn't see this coming? You think it shocked him? You never know what you are until you end up with a little pressure torque to you. You listen to what I'm telling you. You don't ever know who you are until they come to you and say, your son just died. Then you find out. Because that causes something. Listen, I'm telling you, if I didn't have Jesus in my life, I'd still be high and drunk. I would have OD'd. I'd have been like them disciples, but I knew the Spirit of God was speaking to me and saying, you trust in me, don't trust in that. You trust in me, don't trust in that. You keep your faith in me, you keep your hope in me, you keep your joy in me, you keep it in me. Don't you look to that stuff. You keep your eyes on me. Because some people say, well, there have been a bunch of people went through. Yeah, they sure have, but there have been a bunch of people blowed their brains out. There have been a bunch of people turned alcoholics. There have been a bunch of people got drunk, got high, went right back to dope, because that's what I would have did. If I didn't have the Spirit of God in my life, I'd have been like Peter when he said, when Jesus got crucified, Peter said, I'm going fishing. The mother disciples said, I'm going fishing too. They went back to what they knew. You don't think I didn't want to go back to what I knew? I didn't have my mind saying, going back to that, if you'll go back to that dope, this won't bother you. The Holy Spirit was saying, don't worry about it. It won't bother you. You know, you're going to get through it. I'm holding you up. Think about it. Then when you go through something, you find out where you're at. When you go through a sickness or a disease, or you go through a trial or a tribulation, or you go through death in your family, or you go through anything, people say, well, ain't no one really died in my family. Put your seatbelt on. It comes because it just happens. It's just part of life. The corona disease is going to get on people. It's part of life. It's going to happen. I can barricade myself if I want to, but Wednesday night I've already been in touch with someone. There's people that say that everyone's done been in contact with him. So I'm just trusting God. That's all I can do. Because if I stay at home, there's going to be someone come to my house that's been in touch with someone else that can't. I'm going to go to the gas station. I'm going to get gas. I'm going to go to the store and I'm going to get food. And I'm not smart. I try to stay clean, but sometimes I catch myself going in. You see what I'm saying? I don't have no choice but to trust him. When they told me my son, I didn't have no choice but to trust him. When they told my grandson, I don't have no choice. When they told me that cancer's in the area, diabetes is in the area, did you know herpes been around forever? Did you know cancer? More people going to die from cancer. Listen to what I'm trying to tell you. Listen, stay at home, be safe, but definitely make sure that your hope and your trust is in God. If you go to Walmart and you see somebody in a full suit, don't think none of this thing. Praise God. If I had one, I'd probably have it on in here. Huh? I feel more safe here. But don't you worry. If I run out of food, I'll go to the grocery store. There's that manna. If I run out of money, I'm going to work. If they'll let me work. Amen? It's just life. We're going to do them things. All right, I got to close. For as the body without the spirit is dead. Now, I done pretty much gave you that passage, but listen to what I'm telling you. And I'm getting ready to close. It's been 30 minutes. I got to close. He said, for as the body without the spirit is dead, so faith without works is also dead.
Have you ever went to a funeral and looked at that body? And they in there just dancing to the music and singing. And no, because they're gone. So he's saying, just as the body without the spirit is dead, so is faith without works. You got to have some works in your faith. Amen? So this is what I'm going to show you. I said, what I'm preaching on, it is a lot about faith, but it's also about there's only one God. So I'm going to give you a scripture. Jesus is on the earth. We're going to Matthew 8:29. It said, and behold, they cried out. Now, Jesus is coming on scene, and there's a bunch of demons possessing people. Listen to what it said. And behold, they cried out, saying, what have we to do with thee, Jesus, thou Son of God? Art thou come hither to torment us before our time? They recognize the, oh, no, it's Jesus. It's God himself. He's in the flesh on the earth. And has he come to torment before our time? Go ahead to Mark. We're going to go to Mark in a couple of verses. Let us alone. What have we to do with thee? Thou Jesus of Nazareth. I told you that before. If you say you believe in God, you ain't made yourself no different than a demon. They believed and knew. And they said, hey, we know who thou art, the Holy One of God. Are you come to torment us before our time? It's not time. Because they knew Jesus could say, go to the swine, you can fit in the dry. You know, think about it for a minute. So watch this. Go on to the next. It said, and cried a loud voice and said, what have I to do with thee, Jesus, thou Son of the Most High God? I adjure thee by God that thou torment me not. Said, Jesus, we know who you are. And we adjure thee by the Most High God. Hey, listen, when you swore by no one, you couldn't swear by no one else but yourself. And we're telling you, don't torment us. Listen, go ahead. I'm closing. I know we ain't got no one to play the keyboard right now, but I'm closing. Luke 4:34 says, saying, let us alone. What have we to do with thee, thou Jesus of Nazareth? Art thou come to destroy us? I know thee, who thou art, the Holy One of God. Listen, brother, you realize it or not, the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. God himself came and walked among us because the Word is God and was God and will always be God. Listen, I'm just trying to help us. Cancer don't shock him. Corona don't shock him. Diabetes don't shock him. Huh? Listen, I'm telling you, he's God. Don't you know that there's certain people that when that stuff comes up on, they say, in the name of Jesus. Now, this is gonna terrify some people. Get out! And the devil got to flee? And there's some people say, in the name of Jesus, get out! And the devil says, who are you? Jesus, I know. Paul, I know. Lord, I know, but who are you? Who are you to talk to me like? You better get ready to get naked and get whipped. Someone said, listen, some of y'all ain't Bible students. I better give you a drop on that. That's over there in Acts, and it's where the sons of Sebek, I can't say his name, someone else can say it, but they run up in there and bust up, and they're going to cast out because they saying that the men of God was doing it. They thought, hey, if they can do it, we can do it in the name of Jesus. God's taking care of them too. We can be took care of. They got took care of, all right. Stripped down naked and laughed at. I'd been over there laughing. You run out naked, I'll probably laugh. Lord help them. They need to get with Jacob and go to the gym. No, I'm just kidding. Amen. Glory to God. Oh, y'all don't get mad at me. Acts 16:17. Listen to Acts 16:17. The same followed Paul and us and cried, saying, these men are the servants of the Most High God, which show us the way of salvation. I don't know about you. There ain't a lot of people yelling that today, are there? That was someone demon-possessed recognized that. They don't really recognize that today. These are the people that go to church over there with their nose in there like they just don't care. Oh, I'm singing now, ain't it? Ain't that it? Hey, glory to God.
There's a reason they don't call on you to pray for them. I got people lie all the time. I get around people all the time and they say, he's a good man. No, 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 the only good in me is God. Don't get mistaken. I'm not good. The only thing good in me is God. He gets all the glory, all the praise, and all the honor. Trust me. But they recognize that's a servant of the Most High God. That's a servant of the Most High God. That's a servant. That's a servant. That's a, there's certain people I can point to. There's some people I'd be afraid I'd tell a lie, so I got to be careful. I'm in trouble already. Listen, I got a new idea, Cal. You can put this on live stream. If you don't like what I preach, keep it to yourself. Don't call me. I ain't answering your phone call. I'm going to leave. Woo! I'm going to leave the premises, and I'm going to go eat and drink and be married till Jesus come back. And I'm already married, so I ain't getting married again. Leave that alone. Listen, this is our responsibility to show the way of salvation. Ain't got nothing to do with coming to church today, so don't worry. There's already enough people that's mad over that because I just said a few things that I said. It's just the Bible. Don't worry about that. It's just the Bible. I just preached the word to you. I just covered a lot of ground. There's some people that's so scared. There's some people that's not. It ain't the people that go here, but there is some people so scared, they're scared plumb to death. Them people need to stay home because they function in fear and not in faith. Matter of fact, they sure don't need to go to the store. They need to call the church, get in touch with Sister Vicky, let her go to the store, pick up their stuff, and bring it to them. It's happening. It needs to be done. Listen, I'm trying to help us. Because if you operating in fear and your faith ain't got no works, you need to, hey, I've said something right then. I'm telling you. I know I've been saying the whole service now. If he wants me, he can get me. Because, listen, he can drop me dead of a heart attack anytime. And he can justify it. When I get there, he can say you was a little fat. And what am I going to do, argue with him? I'll be like, yes, sir. You told me to slow down. Yeah, you told me to walk a little bit. Well, he probably, if you listen right, he probably told me to walk a lot. Hey, listen, I'm just trying to keep it simple. I'm trying to be honest. I ain't trying to sugarcoat. I never have, Brother Jarvis, I never will. I won't change my preaching for people. If God called me to this, what he called me to. If he's called me to 20 people, that's what'll be after the plague. We won't have but 20. Someone said, what are you saying? Some of them might get mad over the way I preach. May not never come back. You know what that means? Some other poor church will be plagued. I didn't say that, did I? Hey, listen, I've done it before. There have been people come here, Brother John, that said, God called me over here, but I had a problem with my pastor. I basically ran them out the door. I said, then go back to your pastor and get that worked out. Don't you bring your baggage over here. That's what's wrong. People go, you know what happened? Everybody went wrong from church to church. Ain't nobody want your lazy members, no way. Man, I'm in trouble again. I want some people that's trusting in the rock, the solid rock of salvation. I want some people that people look at and say, now they showing us the way of salvation, and his name is Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Showing us the way of salvation. It's in Jesus only. I'm in trouble, so you may have to come up and finish. But I told the truth. May not be but 5 families, may not be but 10. May not, but there's a remnant of people want the truth. Huh? What if everybody quits, and everybody stops, and nobody does nothing? Huh? Joshua put it like that. He said, as for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord. He said, as for me and my house, he said, don't you be discouraged. He said, you be encouraged. Huh? He said, be courageous. Woo! Listen, if you're fearful, you got a whole lot more things to be fearful of than this. There's some things going on in the background. You think it's bad now, huh? You better get the clippers out and clip them fingernails, because there's going to be some things happening in the future going to make you chew your fingers off. Huh? You better get some stability. You better get some strength. Better get some faith. Better get some hope. Better get some joy. Whew. You done it. Man, you give me scriptures when I came in. Huh? I already had enough and he gave me more. I'm like, no, don't put that in my head. I'll preach that. Stand to your feet. I'm done. Look, I'm done. I'm done. I'm done. Glory to God. Ain't you glad? Listen, if we'd have sung for 4 or 5 songs, I'd have had you in here at 12:30 today. As I feel the presence of God. Listen, tonight going to be live stream. Wednesday night going to be live stream. Next Sunday morning, Lord, glory to God. Lord willing, I mean, unless they shut the country completely down and say don't, I'll be here preaching Sunday morning. And if the rapture occurred, don't you worry about nothing. Sister Lisa and Brother Jarvis and them will have a service still going on up in this place. Woo! I'm just kidding, brother and sister. I love y'all. Y'all going. We going. Glory to God. This is what I want us to do. We're going to stay 6 feet apart. I love you. But we can pray from where we're at. Or if you want to get an altar, you can get an altar. Just be very respectful. But if you need special prayer, I'm praying for you. I'm just crazy enough to believe. I am crazy enough to believe that God's got his hand on me enough that if he tells me to pray for you, I'm going to pray for you. Hey, if he did it for Lester Summerall, you know what happened? When the plague got on him, it was dead. It got on something it wasn't used to. So, whoa, this ain't dead faith. This is real faith. I can't even live here. Huh? I'm in trouble. Ain't? That's what it says. If you say in the name of Jesus, you got to go, it's got to go. If you firm and you believe it, it's got to go. Huh? There's people right now watching live stream. I hope he gets the corona. They probably, you know what? They say, what you're hoping for just happened. Not to me. You got to be careful. Now, I pray not. I pray for that protection. I pray for this whole church. From the praise team to the sound booth to the secretary to everyone, that God keeps his heads in protection. But God, not only on your children, but all the children and all the people. There's a demon. There's a plague going out throughout the world. In the name of Jesus, we pray dies. You don't want no one to die. You want everyone to live, and you want everyone to come to the knowledge of Jesus Christ and be born again. That's why he said, I adjure thee by the Most High. These men are the men and the women of God showing the way of salvation. Walking out your faith. There's some people you don't want praying for you. Gideon, I'll show you who to pick, Gideon. You have a remnant of people that you can trust, Gideon. That'll be right by your side, Gideon. Moses, there's a few people you know is going to have your arms. And when you get tired, they're going to hold you up. You know why? Because we went in the battle. We winning. In the beginning, we won. In the middle, we won. In the end, we won. And when the pastor's hands get tired, someone holds their hands up. That means we're together. You know what? Hey, Gideon, there's a few people you know got you. Them's the one I want you to get. Them to get down there and just... can them. Them that are watchful and ready for battle. He said, you can run with them. Huh? Amen. Oh, praise God. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. The one that's getting baptized, if you'll get ready. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for this day. God, I thank you for your word. God, you know, God, And you're watching, you're hearing, you know my heart, and you know my spokes. God, everything I said, I felt. led of you, God. I felt like you laid it in my heart. I felt like you give me the scriptures to show God you're God. You ain't sharing that with corona. You ain't sharing it with cancer. You ain't sharing it with diabetes. I'm telling people, and I believe it with all my heart, God. People are panicking, talking about how bad and how big corona is, but I'm telling you how big and how bad is my God, and his name is Jesus of Nazareth, of the Most High God. And every sickness and every disease will bow at the name of Jesus. Will not come nigh. Will not have authority over your life. Glory to God. Jesus, we give you glory. We give you honor. And we give you praise. And we glorify your name, God. I worship you in this time of tribulation and trial, God, when it looks like it's on every corner. But I worship you, God. Lord, I thank you, God, for an army of people that'll stand and say glory to God. Listen, and someone said, I can do it from home. I can too. And it may end up that way. It may end up to where we preach from home, but we're still going to preach. Glory to God. Lord, I pray, God, that we're able to show the way of salvation, which is in Christ Jesus and him crucified. He's who I put my trust in. Lord, I'm making that statement bold and I'm making that statement loud. Corona may be big. Cancer may be big. Diabetes may be big. Poverty may be big. All these things of this life may be big. But there ain't nothing that's able to dethrone my God. He's God all by himself. And he gets all the glory and all the honor and all the praise. And everything else is questionable. But he is King of kings and Lord of lords. He rules and reigns, and he's soon to come. And he's looking for a church that has adorned herself, that has made herself ready. And Jesus, we stand in the gap for your children. We pray, God, your protection upon your children like never before. I'm praying for your heads to be about them and your protection to be upon them. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. God bless you. Glory to God. Thank you. Jesus.